Dear students, welcome to DACJ Home Classes, our digital initiative by Directorate of School Education, Jammu. I, Jyoti Diwan, has brought a new story for you, titled Love Across the Sar Desert by K.N. Daruwala, Class 12th, Chapter 11th. It's very beautiful and amazing love story of Najib and Fatima. Najib from India and Fatima from Pakistan. Before we start the story, we must know something about the author. K.K.N. Daruwala is an Indian Parsi poet and short story writer in English language. He is also a former Indian Police Service officer. He was born in 1937 in Lahore. He joined the Indian Police Service in 1958 and was eventually appointed as a special assistant to the Prime Minister on International Affairs. He subsequently was in the Cabinet Secretariat until his retirement. He was awarded the Saitya Academy Award in 1984 and Padma Shri in 2014. He received the Commonwealth Poetry Prize for Asia in 1987. Let us have introduction of the story Love Across the Sar Desert. Love Across the Sar Desert is an adventurous story of love. Najib, a 20-year-old boy, crossed the boundary between India and Pakistan at a great risk to his life. While others would cross the border for smuggling bidi leaves and spices, Najib crossed the border to bring his beloved Fatima. His journey to Pakistan was beset with several difficulties, but he remained unafraid. Quite courageously, he succeeded in his mission, inspired by life. Fatima's arrival proved a great blessing as it brought rains to the drought-hit Run of Kutch. The Run of Kutch is a large area of salt marshes that span the border between Pakistan and India. It's located mostly in Gujarat, India, and in some parts of Sindh, Pakistan. It's divided into Great Run and Little Run. Dear students, now we will read the story in detail. In the beginning, when the run had been described, there was drought for 3 years. There was no hope for life. In the meantime, a girl named Fatima came. She proved fortune for the village. The day she arrived, it rained and the drought ended. She was beautiful daughter of spice seller. Her father's name was Kalesha. The chief character of the story, Najib, once visited across the Sar Desert with his father Aftab and fell in love with Fatima at first sight. Whenever Najib and his father crossed Run earlier, each time they used to take tendu leaves with them and purchase spices from there. When Najib and Fatima met each other, Fatima also got attracted towards him, but she was engaged to someone in the village. Aftab used to carry on illegal trade in bidi and cloves. He paid money to the officials who arranged the sale of bidi and cloves on the other side and enabled him to smuggle from there terrilin cloths or spices. Aftab and Najib had a camel called Alarakha and they belonged to the village Khawda. Najib was in love with Fatima. That's why he decided to cross the border in daylight by the help of Alarakha, while none dared do so. It was very hot. While crossing the border, he knew the track that he had to take. Najib crossed the international boundary, pillar number 1066, by crossing the two posts of the Indus Rangers. But he strayed slightly from their watchtower. The Rangers saw through their binoculars this Lee camel. They couldn't stand for an Indian sleeping into their territory with tendulis right under their noses without paying any bribe. They chased him, firing a mile long distance. The spent bullets were flopped in the sand behind him. It caused dust to rise. This dust rose between him and the rangers, but he escaped successfully. He faced many problems. He was injured, but finally he reached in front of Fatima's house. He spent the night in the cattle shed. Early in the morning, he showed the gold bracelet to Kalisha and told him about purchasing gloves. Fatima told him about Mehfooz Ali, with whom her parents and relatives wanted to marry her. Najib asked Fatima whether she would like to accompany him across the run. She, however, maintained silence, and that meant her willingness to go with him. The next evening, she waited. When her father had slept, she went out of house. She joined Najib at the outskirts of the village, where he had been waiting with his camel. He drove the camel hard, and they reached the village Sarbala. She felt tired and fell asleep. When she woke up in the afternoon, the sky was overcast. They continued their journey throughout the night. Najib's father was worried. He was eagerly waiting for the arrival of his son. He opened the door 3 times, thinking his son had come. But it was only the wind that was knocking the door. But now the knocking was repeated and persistent. As he opened the door, he saw the camel Alarakha standing outside. When he asked his son if he had brought anything, Najib led Fatima in. As the girl came in, it started raining heavily. Fatima's auspicious arrival brought an end to 3 years' spell of drought. The coming of Fatima proved auspicious for the whole village. Now we come to the theme of the story. Love Over the Sahel Desert is a romantic love story focused on the idea that true love transcends all boundaries such as culture, place, race, color and creed. It portrays union between two lovers despite their hailing from two opposite sides of the Indian-Pakistan international border to violent nations. There may be many obstacles and problems in the way of true lovers, but their love wins the day after all. Najib, an Indian boy, falls in love at first sight with a beautiful Pakistani girl named Fatima. She is engaged to be married to another man called Mehfooz Ali. She doesn't want to marry him. She gets ready to elope with Najib to India. They have to face a lot of hazards. They have to face the guns of the Pakistani rangers, but they succeed in their mission. The villagers also got rainfall. Thus, true lovers get united in the long run. This story also presents the gory truth of the dwellments in no man's land near international borders. The message conveyed through the story is that there are enemies of nations who do illegal trade and trespass the borders while smuggling toxins, banned drugs and false currency, thus indulging in destroying the innocent lives of people. Najib crosses over the border with mixed intentions and luckily comes back alive. Dear students, now we will read the character sketch of Najib. Najib is a handsome and dynamic young man. In the early part of the story, he is a very shy, introvert and diffident boy. He is being known to blush at a mere mention of a girl. He had eyes which were dreamy. Neither of his peers ranked him among the braves. Also his father Aftab worried that the boy would lose everything he had and his ancestors had earned. His father didn't trust his business skills. Najib proves all his critics wrong. He won Fatima's love and inspired her to leave her country forever. He turned to be a bold, confident, and determined hero. He faces all odds but doesn't give up hope, and ultimately he is successful in his mission. He managed to stage his elopement drama despite all the hazards. Finally, he marries her and brings her home. He is the hero of entire love story of love across the salt desert. Dear students, I have brought some important questions related to the story for you. You will learn more about the story through these questions. Let us start with this question. Why is the lesson has been titled Love Across the Sahara Desert? Why is the desert called a Sahara Desert? Or discuss briefly the title Love Across the Sahara Desert. The lesson has been titled Love Across the Sahara Desert because a lover, Najib from India, crossed the international border by entering in the territory of Pakistan to get his bride. He had promised Fatima that he would come and take her away to India. He fulfilled his promise and eloped with her. The desert of Run is called a Sahara Desert because its sand is saltish in taste. Aftab asked Najib, "Have you brought anything?" Do you think Aftab was happy when he saw Fatima? Aftab was very worried about the safe arrival of his son Najib. He asked Najib if he had brought anything. His tone was harsh and angry. Najib pushed Fatima in. Aftab was happy when he saw his son along with Fatima, though he didn't express happiness on his face. The story ends with the coming of the rain that swept away years of drought. Do you think this helps Fatima in being welcomed into her new home? The answer is, the drought in Kutch had lost it for 3 successive years and everything was badly affected. But Fatima's arrival in the village coincided with the coming of rain that swept away 3 years of drought. They helped a lot to her in being welcomed into her new home. The people of the village still consider her arrival auspicious and a symbol of love across the border. How does the drought affect the following? Earth, camel, oxen, cattle. Earth. The earth gets dried and cracks appear on its surface. Camel. The camel alone survives, feeding on the camel thorn. Oxen. The oxen die due to drought. Cattle. The cattle become thin and weak. Why was Najib's father worried about Najib's future? Najib was an introvert kind of person. He was young and without experience. Moreover, he had gone to Pakistan without his man's support. Najib had taken the law into his hands and thus endangered his own life. He also feared that he would grow too shy to charge the money on what he would sell, and as such would spend wastefully everything, whatever his ancestors and he had acquired for many years. These thoughts made Najib's father worried about Najib's future. Why was a visit to Kala Dungar important for the people of Kavla? Visit to Kala Dungar was important for the people of Kavla because Panch Mepir had left his footprints on the hill over hundreds of years ago. People used to go to pay homage to footprints of Panch Mepir before journey to seek the blessings of Panch Mepir. Was a trade that was carried on across the border legal? Give a reason for your answer. The trade was not legal. It was carried out by bribing the authorities on both sides of the border, like that of Zaman. People of Khavda and the adjoining area made these trips to smuggle Indian goods into Pakistan and vice versa. When he heard about his son's disappearance, what was Aftab's first suspicion? Aftab's first suspicion was that his son would be around when he heard his disappearance. But when he discovered that his camel Ala Rakha was also missing, he suspected that his son might have gone to Pakistan along with the bundles of tendu leaves which he had brought. What made Aftab suspect that his wife knew about Najaf's going away? Aftab gave the news of Najaf's disappearance to his wife. He thought that she would faint on hearing this news. But she reacted quite differently to the news. She didn't even blink in surprise. His eye fell on her bare arm and he found the gold bangle missing. All this made him suspect that his wife knew about Najaf's going away. Zaman was an important person in the village and was called the chief because, take the right answer. A. He was the strongest man in the village. B. His family had ruled the village for years. C. He arranged the smuggling trips across the border and had close contacts with officials on both sides of the border. The answer is C. What was the Zaman's reaction to Najaf's absence from the village? Why? Zaman's reaction was a wave of great anger and disappointment to Najaf's absence from the village. He was the chief of the smugglers and none of them would cross the border without his permission. But Najaf was the first person who had not sought his permission. Zaman was very upset for this reason. He had a tiff with Najaf's father and abused Najaf by calling him pig and son of a pig. He was also annoyed for the reason that Najaf had not given him money to bribe the officials. Fatima says, "Just my luck to run into mutes." Who the mutes she refers to? Why does she make this statement? Fatima and Najaf fell in deep love at the first sight. She had been under pressure to get engaged to a stammerer, namely Mehfooz Ali. She wanted to elicit a word from Najaf but couldn't, for he was a shy, quiet and pleasant young man, so ready with his smiles. She therefore finds the two men unable to speak, one because of stammering and the other because of being shy and reserved. So the mutes were Mehfooz Ali and Najaf. Though Fatima belonged to a different country, she did not hesitate in eloping with a boy from another country. Give two reasons. And the reasons are obvious. First, she did not want to marry Mehfooz Ali, who was a stammerer. Second, she was in the true and deep love with Najaf. Why did the people of Khavda welcome Fatima with open arms? The people of Khavda had suffered for 3 years in succession the misery of the drought. But as soon as Fatima came, it started raining heavily. The coming of Fatima coincided with the storming down of the much awaited rain. Fatima's coming proved auspicious, and so the people of Khavda village welcomed her with open arms and delight. Fatima brought prosperity to the villages in the form of rain. Describe how Najaf fooled Kalesha and brought Fatima home. Najaf had fallen in love with Fatima. He reached her house facing all difficulties and leading his life into danger. He had been chased by police also. He was able to win the confidence of Kalisha by tempting him with a gold bangle. He assured him that he had come for business of clothes for gold. While Kalisha was busy arranging clothes for him, he was successful in befooling Kalisha. He brought Fatima in his village khawda on his camel Alarakha. Thus, Najib was able to befool Kalisha and bring Fatima, his love, to his home. Give the name of the literary devices used in the story Love Across the Sahel Desert. Dharan lay like a paralyzed monster, its assembly. The sand looked like a splash of water, its assembly. A camel looked like a huge prehistoric animal, its also assembly. Fatima was a hoor with eyes. It is a metaphor. Now we end the story with the beautiful conclusion. True love knows no barriers whatsoever. It helps lovers overcome all dangers they face prior to their ultimate union. I hope you enjoyed the story and understood it well. Read books, study hard, stay safe. Thank you very much.